What's up, ladies and gentlemen? I'm Jay Ray, and this is my YouTube channel, Jay Ray Games. So this one, the video that I'm gonna show up, that's gonna show up right now, is gonna be a man. I'm gonna put his channel in the link of the description, so you can see the real video that he had created. But this is what I want to show other people and know that he did a good job at it. So. This man, I just looked on YouTube and I seen him combining PlayStation to Xbox and Xbox to PlayStation. So this one, I'm showing you the X. No, it's not the X Play. It's the X Station. Then this, if you make it up to 2 likes, give me 2 likes. That's all I want. I will make another video that has the play box that he put PlayStation mixed with box and combined them together. He did both of them. He did two. So I'm gonna show you 2 of those maybe today or tomorrow, because I'm going shopping today. So I hope you guys leave a like and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Okay, subscribe. Don't forget to drop on the comments. Do you really want this to happen? Do you really want a game like that, so you don't have to switch out TVs or HDMI cords or the plug, so you can play the Xbox or the PlayStation, because you can play it at once? I'm just saying, leave it on the comments. Jay Ray out.
Hey guys, it's Ed from Ed's Junk. I'm here today. I want to show you another project I've been working on. I'm always doing something. This one I'm actually pretty excited about. I don't know if you guys remember my past video I did. I took one of my Xbox laptops I make, but made an Xbox and a PS4 in one. But it was pretty big to get all those components crammed in there. And then once it was a laptop at that point, who needs it to be portable? It was too big for that. A lot of people said, hey, why don't you make that but without the screen, like a console that has both a PS4 and an Xbox One? Well, with the new slim systems of both versions, I went ahead and did that and created the X Station. This is an Xbox One S and a PS4 Slim crammed into this one case. You have HDMI on the back, power, and then on the front here, you have 2 USBs per console, and then also your disk drives. And these are going to be LED indicators to show you that it's on. Let me go ahead and plug it in, and we'll get this thing booted up. Because it takes a little while, obviously, if you have the Xbox plugged in. Let me show you guys my plug it in here. You're going to hear it turn on, the fans, and then the little light show. That is probably like my favorite part. I love the little light show. I'm going to actually do it again, just for kicks and giggles. And here it is. Boom. Love it. These are indicating what system is on at any given time. You're never going to run both at the same time. It causes too much heat, and there's just really no reason for it. But on this little button here, you have a sync button. I'm sorry, not a sync button, a switch button. You push that, it's going to switch between Xbox and PlayStation. Green and blue colors, obviously. Let's just switch over to Xbox here. And now we're going to boot it up. We have power and eject right on the front, and the sync button's on the side. Let's go ahead and turn that on right now. So what it's doing, it's turning the Xbox on, it's taking the HDMI splitter inside, and it's switching it to the Xbox itself. You're going to see the wonderful Xbox logo up here behind me here in just a second. Again, when you first turn on an Xbox, right from the beginning, it always takes a few seconds for it to kick on. That's just the way it is if you've ever had one. And there it is. This is coming right off the X Station right now. While the Xbox is booting up, I'm going to show you guys. This is an Xbox One Slim and a PlayStation 4. So these are just the cases. I kind of put them together to show you guys. I just want to show you reference here. Like the size, the height here. You can basically get an idea of how compact you kind of slam these things together. I was actually impressed. Both motherboards are sitting inside, one upside down. The heat sinks are aligned in a way so the air blows straight through it and cools both systems. And there's Xbox. Got a controller here, just like you'd use any other normal Xbox. So you can see it's on. Let's go ahead and throw a game in just so you can get an idea. I don't have these games installed yet, but you'll see. It's going to insert in, just like that. And the Xbox is obviously going to read it and pull it up on the screen. Grand Theft Auto 5. And you'll see it here. Pop up. There it is. So that's Grand Theft Auto. And we can eject it as well. Now, what I want to do is I'm going to switch over to the PlayStation 4 side and guys show you that. So I'm going to go ahead and actually turn the Xbox off, because we're actually going to basically be unplugging the system. That's what's going to be happening. It's going to take the power and switch over to the PlayStation side. So you want to shut down your Xbox properly. Even showing love in Brooklyn, now that's blessings on blessings on blessings. I always had a message. God made a way, yeah, you guess it. If you don't like it, there's preference. Just and this is just something I kind of made for fun. I wanted to see if I could do it. This isn't something I'm going to be like mass producing like my laptop systems, but kind of just a fun project just to show. So let's switch over to the PlayStation side now. All right, now PlayStation is enabled. Grab the controller here. Power button just in the front, eject and power. We'll turn off. You heard a little beep, it's kind of hard to hear. Now the HDMI splitter has switched over to PlayStation side. And there is the beautiful PlayStation logo. Both of these systems will switch back and forth. There's no need to have multiple HDMI cables through television. One HDMI cable, one power cable, and that is it. Two controllers, and you're ready to go. And here is PlayStation. And again, just for kicks and giggles, I'll show you guys. I'm going to plug a PS4 game right into it. Again, just sucks right in the front there. And then it'll pop up here in a second. I personally love this thing. I think it's great. It's probably one of the most beautiful looking consoles I've ever actually built. And there it is, Advanced Warfare. Again, we can eject it just from the front here. Ooh. All right, we're gonna turn this off. All right, guys, that's the X Station. Thanks for checking it out. To see more about my videos, subscribe. And also go to my channel. You can see all kinds of stuff from my Xbox laptops, PlayStation 4 laptops, all my gaming modifications, console modifications that I've done. Some of it's to order, some of it's just to show. Thanks, guys, and have a great day. But it feels so good, thinking a lot. Never lie, I'd rather die. So good.